Welcome back, everyone. In part one of Mate, Become the Man Women Want, we covered the five principles of mating success from the book, and in this video, we'll cover the five-step process to dating. So be sure to subscribe to our channel and let's jump right into it. Step one, get your head straight. As Max and Miller mentioned earlier, there is a lot of outdated advice and beliefs around dating. So make sure you sort out your perception and attitude. Fix your mental framework around women, sex, and dating. Holding negative biases towards those things will only hinder your chances at successfully meeting and dating women. Develop confidence so that it's easier to put yourself out there and hold your boundaries. And then clarify your goals in sex, dating, and relationships. Do you want a long-term relationship? Do you want to casually date? Or are you just looking for a one-night stand? Do you know what kind of personalities or lifestyles mesh well with you? Pick up hobbies that are active and force you to interact with people, read books, even see a therapist if you feel it's right for you. The better you know what you want, the easier it'll make dating. Step 2. Develop attractive traits. Understand what women want in men and why, and then give it to them. As the authors put it, men have been confused about what women want seemingly since the dawn of time. But really, women's preferences are not all that mysterious. Women typically look for your ability to be effective at life and the willingness to use those effective traits to do effective things. The good news is that you don't have to be a billionaire model to be attractive to women. The authors state that you simply have to not suck. You don't have to have six-pack abs, you just need to not have a beer gut. You don't have to be a billionaire, you just need to be financially responsible. Reflect on your physical and mental health, your intelligence, willpower, kindness, and protectiveness. Are any of those areas lacking? Focusing on your weakest spots first will be far more effective in attracting women than emphasizing your one or two strong skills and ignoring the rest. Step 3. Display attractive proofs. You may be a smart, mentally stable, and well-liked guy, but it doesn't matter much if no one knows it. This is where signaling comes in. When you're trying to display attractive traits to women, always show, don't tell. Anyone can shout about how smart or rich or caring they are, but only people who are the real deal can actually show it. Most women know to ignore any kind of big talk and focus their attention on guys who are displaying positive proofs. These would include social proof of having friends, being funny or outgoing, material proof of financial stability and responsibility, aesthetic proof of being well-groomed and knowing how to dress yourself, and romantic proof of showing interest and commitment in a woman. Step 4. Go where the women are. Location is essential when it comes to dating and finding the right woman for you. Most dating is based on geography. Who's in your proximity? So your city, your college, your workplace, gym, coffee shops, etc. are all quote-unquote mating markets, where you can meet women and plays a factor in how easy or hard it is to meet them. If you live in a small town with a few single women, it's going to be a lot harder to find someone who's a good fit for you than if you live in a big city with millions of single women. You'll also run into different types of women depending on whether you go to a club, the gym, or a coffee shop. The book goes further in depth regarding mating markets, but for best results, you ideally want to find a place with a lot of single women in subcultures that mesh with yours. One of their examples is cities like Austin or New York City might be better for short-term relationships, while other cities like Cincinnati or Louisville would be better for long-term. Step 5. Take action. Now is the final step. Go out and meet women and date them. The authors highlight knowing how to talk to women, how to date women, and even offer sex advice. Never underestimate the value of conversation skills. Women tend to pay particular attention to how you hold a conversation to see if you are mentally stable, smart, kind, empathetic, and your skill, or lack thereof, plays a large part in her attraction to you. Again, the authors break down in detail how to sharpen your conversation skills, but here are the basic rules. 1. Be a good host. 2. Soften your body language. 3. Establish commonality. 4. Gauge and respond to feedback. 5. Don't act too excited or too aloof. 6. Ask questions and actively listen to her responses. 7. Respond with validation, insight, or debate. 8. Connect with vulnerability. And then remember that when you're on a date, it is a mutual assessment. Just as she is evaluating you, you are evaluating her to see if she aligns with what you're looking for, your values, and your goals. Mate is an excellent book if you feel lost when it comes to dating, as they will provide you with a clear step-by-step process of what you need to know and how to get started. But don't forget that you will have to put in the hard work of self-improvement. Fortunately, though, the more you take action, the more you'll learn from your experiences to build a positive feedback cycle and get better and better over time. This book is so dense with useful information on women and dating that my video would probably be close to an hour long if I tried to cover everything. So pick up this book and start reading. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos on dating and self-improvement. And remember to be Beprimo.